Hey everybody, Merry Christmas Eve. How's it going? Santa is on flight radar. Yikes. Zipping the flight levels. That is hilarious. Well, welcome everybody, and hope you're all having a Merry Christmas. We are going to fly to the North Pole. So North Pole, there's actually a North Pole in Alaska. So here's our flight. We're going to go from Anchorage and fly north. More north to Fairbanks, and right here is North Pole, Alaska. Hey, what's up, Lindsay? Awesome. Merry Christmas to you as well. Well, I'm glad that you've got bitten by the bug. Some colored airways. So this is the North Pole, Alaska. It's super Christmassy. Look at this place. North Pole, Alaska. Super cool. Let's go back to here where you can see. I don't want to go here. How the hell do you work Google Maps? This is just some random street. This is 4th Street. Nope. That's also not what I want. Here we go. Good Lord. North Pole, Santa Claus House, and Fairbanks is just right over here. So we could probably try to overfly this and see if we can see anything. Probably not. The ortho in Alaska is freaking terrible. Oh my God, it is a absolute pain in the butt. So it's gonna look kinda goofy, but it's fine. It is what it is, unfortunately. So, yeah. I see that Logan posted the approach plate. That's awesome. The approach plate for the North Pole. So here is our North Pole Bonanza. Got it expertly painted up. Got a little Santa Claus on the tail. Little candy canes and whatever that stuff's called. And our little North Pole logo right here. So this is, again, Anchorage. And should be a pretty fun flight. There is some pretty looking ortho, but for the most part, it is kind of rough looking. So we'll stay in the cockpit. Maybe. But it's not too bad. I don't know if you guys have ever, if you know of a location for better Alaska ortho, let me know, because it's pretty rough. Okay, let's get battery on. Gotta make sure I remember how to start this thing. Get the beacon on. Come on, Carinato. Here we go. We look good. How's that audio? Is that pretty low for you guys? Sweet. Oh, it's on. Stuck on. Start. Avionics Master. Get the Avidyne going. Alright, so what I wanted to do weather-wise is go real world, but make it so you can actually see. Hey, what's up, Finbar? Merry Christmas, sir. Did you and your Mrs. Claus go on your Christmas walk? Okay, so that is now going to be... Get this up, way up here. Runway visual range, 1,300 feet. Good lord. That is horrifying. We're gonna go 35 miles. But at least this will give us the temperature and the winds. Let's see, where's the wind sonic? Let's just get, we could just go to the ATIS, I guess. Check it out. Okay. All right, and the ATIS is 135.5. Hopefully I can even hear this.
Ted Stevens, Anchorage International Information Yankee. 2200 Zulu weather. Wind 270 M12. Visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 26,000 overcast. Temperature -10. Dew point -36.
Oh my god, the dew point is -36. Holy crap, we're gonna need.
Departing runways 25 left, 25 right.
Okay, so we're on 25. So that's all I need to know, really. We're not in any clouds, so we should be all right, but we will need to keep an eye on whether or not we want to put some icing situation on, which is where on this plane? Defrost. See the strobe, we get nav. Defrost, we'll put that on. Aft cabin heat. Cabin heat, so we're gonna put on a little cabin heat here. Defrost. Yeah. Awesome, Finbar. Thank you for stopping in to say hi. Okay, music can come down a little bit. Alright, everything is in the green. We're looking fine, just fine. We got the ATIS, and we need to put in one more spot here. Let's go. This little routing here is basically just to avoid some of the crappier of the ortho stuff. So this is not necessarily direct, but that will take us kind of in a little bit better. A little bit better route. I'm gonna go direct to there. Level 430. There we go. Okay. All right, and we're going up to 9,500 feet. And we're probably going to be on GPS here. How does this weather look? Should we just get rid of the clouds altogether? Let's just get rid of the clouds. It kind of is like unnecessarily depressing. Make it sunny! There we go. It's cold as crap though. Where's the temperature gauge? Oh yeah, here we go. Negative 10. Alright, we're warmed up. And 2.5. Thanks, Fitbar. We're runway 25. Let's pull up where we're at. I'll pull up the map here. We are on the cargo ramp right here, and 25. We'll just go off of 25 right, which is just right here. So that's an easy taxi. And we'll just be Kilo Alpha to the ramp. See you, FedEx. Delivering some presents. Okay, so taxi 25 left via Kilo and Alpha, North Pole 1. Few and scale. Yeah, we could put some texture in there. That's a good call. Add cloud layer. Let's do scattered at up here. Let's see how that looks. That looks cute. Okay. Well, I hope you guys are all having a good Christmas Eve so far. Any traditions or plans that you guys have for today? Taxiing still sucks. Christmas Eve pizza. That sounds totally amazing. Okay, let's get this up to 9,500. Whoops. Oops. Yeah, that does sound awesome. 1,500. Whoops. Looks good there. We've got being quite merry on the rum. Nice, spin bar. Hell yeah. Some rum and coffee. Do you like put it in anything or just go straight rum? We're gonna squawk 1, 2, 2. Did I get the altimeter?
Ted Stevens, Anchorage International Information Yankee. 2200 Zulu weather. Wind 270 at 12. Visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 15,000 scattered. Temperature minus 10. Dew point minus 36. Altimeter 2984. Arriving runway 25 right. Departing runways 25 left. 25 right. Advise on initial contact, you have Yankee. Ted Stevens, Anchorage International Information Yankee.
Click regions are not very happy. Alright, so we got the altimeter set. We got our clearance to take off. Final looks good. End of the runway looks good. Let's take the brake off. Let's go full mixture. We'll should add those on. So we don't really need that. The panel lights do look pretty nice. All right, let's do it. Hey, what's up, Max? This is the Carinato A36 Bonanza. And we're going to depart over the water, make this departure a little bit interesting. Let's put back on the RPMs. My favorite GA plane is the plane that I fly in real life, which is a Piper Archer PA-28. So that is my current favorite plane, but this is actually, with money no object, this is the best. They're super fast, super durable. Lots of room in it. Pretty simple. Let's get cowl flaps up a little bit. It's gonna get real cold. Dark rum. Blank rum cordial. Yeah, that sounds pretty freaking good, Finbar. Well, this is nice. We're squawking 1, 2, 2, 4. We've got our North Pole livery looking nice. Our mustachioed pilots nice and warm with the cabin heat on. Flying down. That actually looks pretty nice. That airport is super cute looking. In the mountains. Damn, this is looking good. Let's get our taxi and landing lights coming off. Bang the wings a little bit. So the route is, let me pull it up. It's Anchorage to Fairbanks. And we're just flying along the water here, and then heading north after Palmer. So we're just flying this waterway right here just to have some scenery. Downtown Anchorage, which is what we just passed back there. And then we could probably just start climbing now. And we're freaking hauling ass right now, which is awesome too. So we're cruising. We're gonna be cruising at 9,500. That'll keep us clear of any mountains. This looks like an Air Force base right here. Yeah, the ortho for Alaska is a complete disaster. It's such a pain in the ass. But some of it looks pretty nice. Why we're so out of trim here. Let's get this thing back into trim. I don't know why it's doing that. Yeah, it just like wants to pull hard left. So let's go autopilot, let's go heading, and see if it will hold that heading. And we need to get these closed too. Hey, what's up, Gail? Take this off, is it going to be trimmed? Nope, it's going to want to pull to the left again. Alright. It's going to be fine for now. You got it, Gale. We are flying to the North Pole. This thing sounds so good. Nice too. Let's see if we can actually climb out a little bit more VY-ish. It's a cool little town down there. We're coming up to 6,000. We've got a true airspeed of 135, and we've got a ground speed of 144. That's pretty nice. We got a 12 knot tailwind helping us along. That's good. Let's actually get this. Vertical speed at plus 500 feet per minute, not negative, please. And let's actually go 600. Let's see if 600 will work. And we can also go to, once we cross this line right here, we'll put it on nav mode, and that should. So right now it'd probably bang to the right. By the way, look at Look at the ortho. Like, it's just missing huge chunks out of it. Like, that's not snow. That is just missing ortho. yeah, Gail, this is the Bonanza. 836 Carinato Bonanza. Barely doing a good job on our lean situation. Engine temps are coming back up, which is nice. Let's go to nav mode now. It's going to start turning to the left. Good on our route. We are going to this Woods Palmer field, which is straight over our nose, obviously, because we're flying directly to it. But this little waterway ends kind of up here and then follows this river up, and we're just kind of aimed right up there. So we're making pretty good time. We can actually probably, I mean, we're still climbing, so we don't want to go too, actually, we could climb that a little bit heftier than that. Let's go up to 750, 800, let's go, that's right, 800. It's going to, the airspeed is going to start to lower, but we're going plenty fast. There's 9,000 feet. Max, I mean, I can email you the file if you want it. It's pretty rough. It's, if you can, you can kind of see like the end number behind there. Like, that's not good. Got some, what do you call that, poly on the bottom. The North Pole actually ended up looking nice. This side looks a little bit better. You can still kind of see some of the end number there. And got those two wingtip ones. Not great. Santa's looking good, tail there. You are guessing correctly, Ryan. Yeah. I made it in about 10 minutes. Oh, it looks like we are at our cruising altitude. Let's let's check to make sure that we are not going too fast here. We are. We want to be 2250 squared. Yeah, it took about 10 minutes. Yeah, I really, really didn't, I could have done a better job on that. But the Alaska Ortho gave me more problems. Okay, there we go. It's four too many minutes. Look at how cute that looks though, right? I like it. I like the wingtip ones. All right, we're coming up on a little airport right there. Check that out. That looks pretty nice. It does have a certain shaggy charm. So does this Alaskan Ortho. That's a nice one. Is 9,500 enough for those mountains? Good God. Did we plan that correctly? That's 6,900, 7,000, 8,000. All right, so we're going to be 1,500 feet above the tallest peak there. 9,200 is the lowest safe altitude. That looks fine. 9,500 is fine. That just looks like we're going... Ooh boy, that does not look fun. We're gonna keep an eye on the engine, because if anything goes wrong here, we're screwed. Temps look fine. They're a little low. We're at 25C. So that's... Why are those not on? Looks nice. Let's go over to the left tank. Okay. We got heat is good. Fuel pump. They don't need that on right now. Just humming away. Prop. Ice. I mean, we're not running into any icing. I mean, it is cold, but there is no clouds at all. We're at 23 squared, just about. Got RPM, manifold pressure. We're cruising at 158. True airspeed 175 and 173 over the ground with a square right crosswind. Left crosswind. Yeah. I mean, I guess that looks pretty good. Fox. One MOA has a 2,700 sector, but I don't know if you're flying through that though. The Fox One MOA, no, I'm not actually. I am just skipping that one, but they are cold. I called ahead. Well, that looks okay. That Arthur looks pretty nice right there. Rad. All right, so Ryan has family pizza night. What else? Who else has a good Christmas tradition, Christmas Eve tradition? It is very snowy up here. No, we were actually in California for the first time ever for Christmas last year. And this is our first Christmas in California in our own house, which we're looking forward to that. So cute. That looks cool too. Yeah, oh, this would be so sketchy. And look at this, look at how close we're gonna get to this crap. Let's get the hell up to 11.5. Yeah, like maybe if you had a Cirrus. Okay, so this is the tile that I was trying to avoid, which we're gonna do a pretty good job of avoiding that. It looks like it's just snow if you zoom back, but if you zoom forward, you can see that it is no image, no picture. So stupid. Like at least this is in the mountains and not like in the middle of a desert or something. Because that would look ridiculous. But yeah, I was like flying. I just did like a little test and I was like, oh wow, it's like really snowy over there.
Bank angle.
And then of course I get over here. Eyes. Eyes on the sky. Merry Christmas, sir. 4 months in a row. That is crazy. Merry Christmas to you and Julia and everyone. Thank you so much, Eyes. Merry Christmas to you as well. Thank you for the subscription and 4 months. That's awesome. I had this problem. We did the sim to table, the salmon, Alaskan salmon sim to table. There was just, it was a mess. The ortho in Alaska was a nightmare. There were some that had, just had clouds over it, and I thought it was snow, but it was just clouds. There were a couple of missing sections like this. I'm sure somebody out there has like a full collected nice version of Alaska, because it would be really pretty to have this fully orthoed and do some Alaska flying. But this, the ortho 4XB, just kind of like the regular do-it-yourself, terrible. Default is actually not that bad in some spaces, but it is really cool when you're in the towns to have the orthos. Like coming into Fairbanks, it looks pretty cool. Well, hello, Maria. Merry Christmas to you as well. Everyone, say hello to my mother. Gale ortho is just kind of the name for the method of getting these photorealistic tiles. Look at that glacier. That is cool. Two big glaciers going into one. Wow. That looks cool. I don't know. We're in between Fairbanks and Anchorage, so I don't know where that is. Don't look over there. We're only looking to the right. That looks pretty awesome. Lots of snow over here. Maria, did you like the Christmas decorations I put on the plane? We're already up to our 11,500, I think. Yep. Speed is creeping back up a little bit. I think you can actually see it once we get closer to Fairbanks. Yeah. Ho, ho, ho. Yeah, my uncle climbed McKinley a few times. And Kilimanjaro. And he didn't do Everest, but he was up. He got up pretty high. Kathmandu. His Sherpa was named Shitty Man. Shitty Man. Still looking good. Temperatures are still looking good. How's the outside temp? It's getting colder. Creeping up to negative 30 now that we climbed up a couple thousand feet. We're still... tracking our line pretty good. Looks good. Merry Christmas, Nightbot. Ho, 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 Nightbot. Yeah. Rudolph is the name of my ADS-B weather. We still got. Oh, now we're gonna be flanked by crap tiles.
Son of a bitch.
Okay, look dead ahead. Dead ahead, zoomed in. Oh! Where'd you go? There you go. I think that was headrest? Yeah, that was the headrest. I would have two, Ryan, and I had thought about it, but then I didn't really find it. I looked, but I wanted to get it done quickly, so I didn't look that hard. Let's see if I can pull one up here. Oh, maybe that's the nose cone. Yeah, I'm not sure where it is. There's a couple of things that it might be, but there's not really like a distinct cone looking thing. Yep, I don't know. Yeah, they're really kind of a mess. Okay, we're okay on fuel. We have plenty of fuel on board. Did you fly over Gig Harbor on your way up? Not in a Bonanza, Maria. No, we started in Anchorage. We can fly over Gig Harbor later. I'm glad I got this hat on with the headphones, too. I don't know, Ryan. I don't know. I think it's probably because I have a, like, total left crosswind coming. But I don't know if this is... if it moves the yoke like that. Oh, it does, yeah. It definitely does. Yeah, so it's just flying into the wind right now. Yeah, so if I turn this off, it's probably just trimmed like that. Maybe not. Yeah, who knows? Who knows? It is pulling to the left, though. So I think it's some trim setting. Oh, yeah, here's some clouds. So it's an ortho, like a pretty good looking ortho with just clouds stuck on it. Come on. Okay, we're almost out of ortho hell. Where is... Hello, Jeff. Today is Christmas. Very good. It's Christmas Eve. Oh, there's Denali. 20,000 foot feet. We actually might be directly... Yeah, it's... So McKinley is right out there. It's not gonna draw in, but... Hey, what's up, Stepan? Australia. Yes, Jeff. Exactly, I think. But we're not sure. Because nobody knows what you're talking about. And this thing sounds awesome. Yeah, there's something goofy going on with the control surfaces. Like, this, we should not be in, like, a full-on nose down. Yeah, I think it's surrounded by like some other pretty high peaks, right? There's 13,000 foot peak, 17,000 foot, 14, 19, 4, 12, 5, 13, 2, 12, 2. The peak is 20,300. Yeah, the base looks like it's showing 68,500. Yeah, I don't think it is either, honestly. It sounds super good, and a lot of the textures are nice, but it's definitely doing something weird. I'll tell you what else is not optimized. This ortho. Like, just because we're overhead, that doesn't look too bad, but that is clouds in the ortho. And this ortho is like zoom level 4. And this is all supposed to be 16, but that looks like it's zoom level a million. And then it goes back to nice over here. Zoom level A. Yeah, so this is the range over here for McKinley, Denali, whatever. It's just not drawn in. Because it's super far away. Okay, let's do a little scan again. Manifold pressure looks good. RPM looks good. It's a little, creeping up a little bit. Indicated airspeed is a little bit low. It's super cold. I wonder if we can just throw that on a little bit. See if there's any ice buildup. But I doubt it. Ground speed's still looking pretty good. I mean, it's 172 miles an hour. Pretty good. Or 172 knots over the ground, which is even more. That's... What is that? What's 172 knots in miles per hour? 172 knots in miles per hour. Almost 200. 197.9. So if we are going... If we get that to 173, that will be... Let's see if we can... Let's go full on the manifold pressure. Is that going to help? Fuel flow does look pretty decent. 13 gallons per hour. Let's pull some more prop out. Pretty thin up here. it's not really... it a little bit. Is it gonna... I want that to move up. I want that to go up a couple. That guy right there. Yeah, does it even have the dial for the true airspeed? Once we land at the North Pole, Ryan brought to our attention a fantastic poem. So we'll read that once we're on the ground. It's amazing. Fuel still looking okay. They look pretty matched right there. Looks like 172 over the ground is the best we can do right now. 174 true. Unless the winds change a little bit. You can just see McKinley kind of popping in there, and then it goes away when you look at it. It comes back. That's weird. It goes away. Looks pretty cool. B2 volume plugin. No, I did not. All right, have a great rest of your Christmas Eve, Finbar. And give a big Christmas hug to Mrs. Finbar. Yeah, I kind of remember that. I bought this. This was the first plane that I bought from the Oryx store. It's, for being an X-Plane 10 plane, it's not bad at all. I've flown the crap out of this thing. Christmas hydration. So how's the little chat box in the right bin? Not too distracting? I'm gonna start doing a better job of putting these up on the YouTube channel, and I feel like it helps with a little bit of context. Put it over there. my lovely decorations that you see on the corners. The Merry Christmas. I actually think those little corner things look turned out really nice. We're Christmassy as hell. It's the Christmas Julia. You can see the Christmas Julia hand right there. Show them your Christmas nail, Julia. Nice little party nail right there. Ho, ho, ho. Yeah, it's a little bit hard to read. When it's in the Piper, it's a little bit easier because it's a darker panel than this one. Like, this is pretty light. So it's kind of tough to read, but the Piper's a little bit better. Yeah, the boxed one is a little bit tougher. Card got going on here. It's pretty good. Like 1 to 2 degrees. Iowa, hang on. I thought I forgot something. Booting up. I gotcha. What's up, White Lick? Chatbot is booting up. Damn it, how did I forget that? Probably because it's Christmas and we got a million things going on. Merry Christmas to you too, Iowa. Hope you guys are having a relaxing Christmas Eve. Hey, take your time. Chatbot, jeez. You got there, Iowa. Nice. Oh, God. Fly and see. Merry Christmas to you as well. Thanks for stopping by, everybody. On our way to North Pole, Alaska, over some very spotty ortho scenery. And Chatbot just does not want to fire up. Let's give him another shot here. Chatbot, let's do it. Chatbot just might not be in the Christmas spirit. So we might have to continue to go audio clipless. So, we got any other Christmas Eve traditions? Ryan has pizza night. I have bacala, making some salted cod Sicilian stew. Chatbot is really being a jerk. I love bacala. It's soaking right now. Have to rinse that out a couple more times before we cook it. Potato pancakes. It's a good tradition. Are you working tonight, Eyes? Chatbot is really, really hurting right now. All right, you work tomorrow? Nothing planned except simulator. Nice, Iowa. We celebrate on Thursday night and Saturday night with family. All right, on. What time do you work, Ryan? Hoping to go home for New Year's next week for a late Christmas with the family. That'd be good, Eyes. 7 a.m., so I'm off at 3:30, and it's all OT. Hell yeah. Well, that's not too bad. I wonder why Chatbot is being such a little bitch about it. Some more weirdo ortho stuff happening over there. Oh, there we go. I think. All right, just because it is Christmas, I'm gonna disable one of these. But it'll go back. It'll go back.
Cessna Skyhawk 204. Oh, fuck.
Yeah, I was too slow. Correct, Ryan. The old Christmas Juliet. Oh, yeah, of course you called it. Merry Christmas. This is looking a little bit better, kind of. Oh, there's some autogen river over the Ortho River. That looks like an abomination. We're looking good. Oh yeah, we need Iowa's.
Watch the birdie.
I like that one as well, Iowa.
We're looking good. Oh, we're looking good.
Oh, freaking Tony. Oh, speaking of Tony, so big news. I am cleared for my cross-country solo this Saturday, which I am very excited for. I just asked. It's like, hey, would you... Because he's going to be off for a week. And I just felt like I was like, you know what? I debriefed that flight a gazillion times. I'm ready to do it. So I just asked him since he's going to be off. It's like, hey, dude, would you be cool? Would it be cool if I did my solo on Saturday? And he's like, yeah, man, let's get you going. So I was like, all right, friggin' day. He's like, what day exactly? I'm like, Saturday. He's like, okay, cool. Oh, by the way, here's McKinley. Oh, it's doing its weird pop-up thing. So yeah, I'm pretty excited about that. That will keep me well under 20 hours. Let's see. Let's check the old flight log here. Not that it really matters, but total flight 14 and a half. So 17.8 total hours. 17.8 total hours. 1.1 of them was with Brad and the Bonanza. And then 2.2 were in 172s before I actually started the training. So if you take away 3.3, I am at just about 14 hours. 14 hours in the Piper, actually training. So that's kind of cool. That ortho looks really terrible. That looks nice. Oh man, that looks really cool right there. Dang. That's so stupid. Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous when I look at it like that and actually add it up and think about that. Like 14 hours to solo cross country is pretty preposterous. But it's so weird. I was genuine when I asked them. I was like, I feel like I am ready to do this flight. Like, I have absolutely no question that I'm ready to do that flight. And you guys, most of you guys watched a lot of it and know that just from what we were going over, there was nothing in that flight that caught me off guard or was anything that I didn't know. You know, it's just a matter of practicing, you know, certain techniques and fine-tuning things here and there, but the actual, taking off, easy. Navigating, easy. Radios, easy. Landing, easy. You know, it's all the little things that you can't replicate in the simulator that needs the most work. Trimming the plane out correctly, getting it leaned appropriately for that plane. And all that stuff will come with hours as I keep going, but yeah, it's pretty silly. Okay, 75 miles out. So I want to find out what my top of descent is like, and we're going to be at 11.5, and our speed is 175. Let's recalculate that and generate nav log. How's our ground speed looking? We still have that crosswind, which is so stupid. Top of descent is 21 miles out. This shows you where we're at. We're next to those MOAs. So this is that Fox 1 MOA. 71 miles out. Pretty close to our descent. And the ATIS is a little bit too far away. Probably got another 30, 25, 30 miles until that starts, until that kicks in. But it'll at least be queued up and ready to go. Fly NC, thank you so much for the subscription. Welcome aboard. Now that I got chatbot up and running, go nuts with the audio. Thank you so much. Merry Christmas, Fly NC. Pretty much right after these mountains, we need to start working our way down. Fairbanks has a elevation of 440, so that's easy. Well, that was a very kind gesture, Ryan and Flancy. Thank you again for the subscription. After this, we're going to start descending. After these mountains here. And we're going to fly over. Okay, Moose Creek has an airport. And it's an Air Force base. Well, I appreciate it, Fly NC. Peek over to this. Oh, Moose Creek is further south. So we know where that is, and we can just fly the river, and we should go right over the North Pole. Here's what I'm looking at here. So here's Moose Creek. Here's the Air Force Base. Let's get this thing. Here's the Air Force Base. That's what I was looking at on the chart. And then you got the river here. Fairbanks here. Fairbanks International is here. And North Pole is basically in between Moose Creek, the Air Force Base, and Fairbanks International. So if we go to the Air Force Base and then fly up freeway or up the river, we'll fly right over the North Pole. And that's what we're here to do. That'll be fun. 58. Okay, we should be getting close to that ATIS popping in here. Yeah, those yokes going to the left is so stupid. I Hey, what's up, Grony Groovy? Welcome, Merry Christmas. We're in the Carinato Bonanza, the North Pole version. And we're flying from Anchorage, Alaska to the North Pole, Alaska, which is just outside of Fairbanks. We're going to actually land at Fairbanks, but we are going to overfly the North Pole, Alaska. It's literally a town called the North Pole. Hey, what's up, Quasar? Sneaking in while the big man's gone. Having some milkshake or hot chocolate. Grony Groovy, welcome aboard officially. Merry Christmas and thank you for the follow. And what I was just showing everyone, you may have just missed it. So here's a Google Earth shot. We're basically right over here, right over this mountain range right now. So we're pretty close. Moose Creek has this Ellison Air Force Base right here. So we're going to, once we get a little bit closer, we're probably going to fly direct to this thing and then overfly the North Pole, which is right here, North Pole, Alaska. Where is Santa's house? Santa Claus's house is right here. This is a pretty cute town. Look at that. How adorable is that? Right. North Pole, Alaska. Super cute. You gotta stay clear of this guy's drone. There's another kind of cool shot. You have like a sign that says the North Pole. So anyway, yeah, that's where we're gonna fly over, and then Fairbanks is just right here. So Fairbanks International will be where we're landing at. Got a little GA ramp here. It's kind of cute.
Fairbanks International Information Zulu. 0000 Zulu weather.
We got the ATIS.
Wind 270 m/12. Visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 14,500 scattered.
I think you can.
Temperature minus 1.
Right, I think there's a workaround. Like if you do it in Sky Vector, it'll actually put that GPS coordinate
right
in there.
Runways 20 right, 20 left. Departing runways 20 right, 20 left.
Okay, 20 right, 20 left.
You have Zulu.
We know those numbers. So we'll be landing a little bit to the south. Enter left base and a 20 left. We can go in the short. The
Fairbanks International Information Zulu. 0000 Zulu weather. Wind 270 m/12. Visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 14,500 scattered. Temperature -10. Dew point -36. Altimeter 2984. Arriving runways 20 right.
Quasar, just listen to some nice Christmas piano music.
20 right, 20 left. Advise on initial contact. You have Zulu.
Just some like generic piano Christmas. Yeah, -36 dew point.
Fairbanks International Information Zulu. 0000.
Yeah, it sounds good, isn't it? It's super relaxing. We've just been like Christmas musicking like crazy, and some of those songs are ridiculous. Like the Hippopotamus song. By the way, this is default. The autogen. And out here it does not look bad at all, but we should have a nice fresh ortho that we can head to. John Siri Christmas album, sweet. Yeah, I'll check that out. Alright, we're getting close. We're almost to our top of descent here. There is the Air Force Base that we want to go to right there. So let's actually go... I think this is it here. Let's check. EIL? Oh yeah, okay. EIL is where we're going. There. So we'll go direct to that guy. We'll go to the right. Can't say the hippopotamus song. No, I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. It's so bad, and her voice is terrible. It's not good. It's some like old-timey song. It's really bad. Let's see here. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. This is really bad. I can only stomach like a couple of seconds of this.
I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. Don't want a doll, no dinky tinker toy. I want a hippopotamus to play with and enjoy.
It's just is what it is. It's just complete, total shit.
White Leg. Beautifully, beautifully played. What the hell? That came on the radio or on like our whatever streaming thing we had going. And is so bad. Holy crap. It is so bad. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Like that spoiled little jackass. You're not getting a hippopotamus, sweetheart, okay? Need to get on that spicy four-flight game. Oh, I know. I cannot wait. Flancy, I am very excited. Initial 3,500, I guess. We'll go down at... We'll go 550 right now. They make Mars attacks. That could be used. That they could use, is what I meant to say, that song to kill the aliens. It's so bad, and the lyrics are ridiculous. Her voice is so obnoxious. It's just terrible. All of it is terrible. It's terrible. White Leg, you nailed it, though.
It's just shit is what it is. It's just complete, total shit.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Ground speed. Okay, it's starting to turn a little bit quartering. So we're now doing almost 180 knots over the ground. And 29. So we should be going down plenty fast. I didn't check the... performance chart, so I don't know actually what the descent should be. It adds so much to the cockpit. Yeah, flying. See, and especially in the airspace that I fly in, to just have that extra backup with the you know, paper chart, the knowledge, the 430, and then the four flight. But I'm really excited for the planning aspect of ForeFlight. That's going to be really cool. Like, spending the time and just, like, fully inputting all the data for the plane and just having everything ready to go. Partially for studying, you know, for checking my work, but for practical reasons, for actually flying, it's going to be awesome. Quasar, I disabled that one, or at least muted it, just for this stream, since it's pretty Christmassy. Exclusively because it's not believed, because obviously Marcus's is equally as aggressive. This tile right here is what we'll be living in. At Fairbanks. So that will be nice. How's our descent coming? Very slowly, actually. Specifically outlined salt flats too. Oh my god, it looks so stupid. I mean, I'm sure there is something. There has to be, right? Let's see, X-Plane 11, Alaska. Ortho. Alaska Project Ortho 4XP on the forums. Oh wow. Yeah. Jeez, that looks pretty nice. Oh my god. When? How old is this thread? January? This is almost a year old. Oh my god, it looks really good. Is there a... I'm just so not the expert on ortho at all that I don't know. I, 50 tiles at zoom level 60 for Alaska. All right. So there's some options if you really wanted to go for it. What's the best ortho source for Alaska? I ended up deleting all the tiles because the BI source, which is what I use, photos were all bad. ARC is good. USGA or USGS. Yeah, there's some other ones that are better than Bing. Miles out, and we're still super up here. Let's dump this thing down even more. How aggressive can we go? We go 1,100 feet. I was just gonna say, just start popping the ears. Should be good. All right, so that Santa's house is right on the freeway. Santa Claus house. I think we should be able to find it. There's like a little river across the freeway, and it's right on the other side. We should be able to spot this. And there's a bunch of roundabouts. That's weird. Here's the river, I assume. And is that the Air Force base that's not popping in yet? That looks like Fairbanks right there. That should be downtown Fairbanks. So here's the Air Force base, and then here is the North Pole. So we're almost there. And then random, taken in the winter, freaking ortho tile. What the hell? This is a mess. Okay, 1,100 feet. Looks like it was a good choice. Okay, I want this Air Force base to pop in here. Oh, there. Okay, there it is. There's the actual airport. Okay. So that is in sight. Now, where is the freeway? All right. So that the freeway or the highway, whatever the hell, is right up against the runway right there. So that is easy to spot, and then we'll just follow that all the way north at like 500 AGL. Oh, there's 350. Let's keep going down. Or we can just take this crap off. That looks awesome. It's gonna be perfect too. It's gonna be right over our left wing. Not if I do it inverted. Merry Christmas. buzz, Mrs. Claus. Yeah, here's the highway right here. And it's gonna head right up there. So there's like a little clearing. Almost looks like a power line clearing in the trees going down to the river that we're gonna cross, and then we're gonna be in the North Pole. Good question, my leg. Global warming is where the snow is. Because we're flying around with leaded fuel, and I'm sure some of you have trucks. Thanks a lot. Alright, here, this looks like it's that clearing right here. It's low lead though, so you're good. It's true. We're only contributing a little bit. We're doing our part. Alright, here's the clearing. It goes out to the river. Yep, and then you got these patches of forest here. Yep. Perfect. Okay. We have one exit, two exits, and then it's right in between the second and the third freeway exit. Okay. So there is exit number one. Okay, by the way, welcome to the North Pole. Welcome to North Pole. There's a little lake, so it is on, it should be right around there. Right here, maybe. Okay, there's a second exit. It's coming up right on the left here. Right there. Santa Claus house. Right there. Yeah, see, check out, look at the roundabouts. This is a very Christmassy thing to do. I'm so super surreal, you guys. Yeah, it's right there. Oh, look at the train. Oh, that looks really cool. Right there. So if I pause that right there, so you've got this little river thing, bunch of trees, freeway exit right here. So if you look at this, So here's that little tree line with the river, the freeway, and there is the Santa Claus house. Holy crap, look at all that. Oh, this isn't even the thing I thought it was. This is Santa Claus house. I don't want to see that. I want this. What is this? That is super cute. Yeah, I want to find that thing. Oh, it actually might be the same place. Find out what that place is. Let's do Santa Claus House, North Pole, Alaska. Oh, it is the same place. All right. Got it. So that's the front of it right there. Whole thing. That's pretty freaking cool. Look at that. We did it! It's kind of covered up by autogen. Awesome. Just awesome. And now we're going to land at Fairbanks. Yeah, we are almost there. All right, so 20 left is the small runway. That sounds familiar. Let's just get this thing ready to go for landing. Tank that is the fullest. No, left is full, so let's go to left. Low bus voltage. We can probably go pull those off. It's warmed up quite a bit. We're above freezing, and there's no clouds anyway. No, that's actually not it. But that is a really awkward location for that. So we're going to fly directly to the back of that. eye out towards that lake right there. There we go. There is the airport. Whoa. Airport right there. So we're gonna just totally fly over this weird airport thing and enter a left base for 20 left. See, the ortho out here does not look that bad. That looks pretty good. It's quite the area. Pattern altitude is 1400, is that right? Yep, 1440 pattern altitude. They chopped this runway up. Very strange. Nice, White Leg. Well, I'm glad that Top Gun reminds you of me. I love that. Hopefully not during the volleyball scene. It's such a great movie. I want some butts, he says.
You two characters are going to Top Gun.
So good. Okay, gears coming down. So we got fuel, we got mixtures, we got props, we got undercarriage 3 green indicating. Got our runway in sight. We are cleared to land. There's the old runway, I think, or that might be gravel actually. Yeah, that is a soft field. And we're going to go on this runway right there. Let's get our approach flaps coming in. Coming down to 100 looks good. Let's actually open up the cowl flaps too. Let's get our second notch of flaps in. Pull the nose up a little bit. Want the glide slope to come back. And we're, of course, doing our John Wayne offset final, which is a bad habit. And winds are 270 at 12, so they're right quarter.
But this plane has 4 engines. It's an entirely different kind of flying altogether.
It's an entirely different kind of flying.
Oh, damn it. This thing is way out of trim. That was terrible. Let's go around. It's floating too much. Let's go real world weather and see what it's like. It might be really nasty. Okay, we'll make left closed traffic. Oh, there's a nice windshield. Oh, this actually isn't that bad up here. get the ATIS back and see what it says.
Fairbanks International Information Alpha. 0:00 Zulu weather. Wind calm. Visibility 10. Sky conditions 20,000 view. Temperature -28. Dew point -33. Altimeter 3008. Arriving runways 20 right, 20 left. Departing runways 20 right, 20 left. Advise on initial contact, you have Alpha.
What did it say our altimeter was? 3008, okay. There.
Fairbanks International Information,
okay.
Alpha.
Now we're set up. We got real world weather. Oh, yeah. 1-6, right? I got that on Blu-ray. It's the most amazing thing ever. Is it on Amazon or Netflix? Let's get the gear coming down. Let's get our approach flaps coming in. Oh, it's actually like on their website. That's awesome. It's so good. Okay, so we got three green, we got full flaps. Everything is still full forward. Comfortably high on the glide slope. Winds are calm. So that was a case of the real world weather being far better than the set custom. And that is a much better approach. Oh, damn it. I let it bounce, yeah. That's right. It's hard to get used to. Oh, look at the wheelie. Oh, there it goes. It does sit a lot higher than that Piper. I let it bounce. I watched it last night, Blu-ray in 4K. That's awesome. Yeah, it's a really, really good looking movie. It's landing light, taxi light going on. Well, that was not the most graceful entrance to an airport ever. And let's go Sierra Charlie to the ramp. Yeah, not the best coming in there, but what are you gonna do? This is a flight simulator with a plane that's not optimized for this. We can go around. I will go around as many times as it takes to have a nice landing. And we're gonna have to rewatch that too. Because I felt like it bounced a long way, but I don't think it actually bounced as much as I thought it did. I think it was just like one big bounce. And then
can
it was
you
fun.
Fly this plane and land it?
Surely you can't be serious.
I am serious. And don't call me sure.
They can't all be good ones. Song. Well, we made it to North Pole. All while Santa is out of town. This is a enormous ramp. Good God. Who the hell is flying here? don't even know what these freaking parking spots are supposed to be for. Yeah, absolutely. I don't know if that's what it's supposed to look like, but... Alright, so let's check out that, that landing. Let's go to the first one. So, the first one was... We had a crosswind. The plane wasn't trimmed right. Oh, this is a float plane. That's kind of cool. Plane was not trimmed right, and it just floated it way too far. The PA-28, you only need, you know, 900, 1100 feet of runway. This thing needs... Look at that, that angle. Yikes. 7-degree crosswind with 12 knot crosswind. Yeah, I was not comfortable with where it was trimmed, so I think I like rotated like aggressively, like whoa, and then look at that, it just like jumps up and then never actually settled back down. Still flying. And I'm like, alright, we haven't touched down yet. It does sit, even in the sim, you can tell how much higher it sits than I'm used to in the PA-28. I think that's a huge part about landing a plane you're not familiar with, is knowing what it looks like when your wheels are on the ground. And there's the real weather coming in. So that was a mess. Going missed. Can't find the tarmac. Alright, so this one looked much better. Obviously the winds were calm, so that's good. Trim is still a little bit weird. Whoa. Looks good there. Alright, it was a big bounce, but then the second landing was great. Hold that back pressure. Aero braking. And it's not flying. What did it even, look like it touched it? Like right here-ish, I want to say. Right. Little rewind thing's messing up with my Merry Christmas. Still on the mains though, and then just kissed it down. I put that camera in the perfect spot. Bunk. All right. So that was not a... It was not the greatest landing ever, but I am actually not mad at that. If that was in real life, I would be happy with that one. This is some beefy landing gear on that thing. Oh, hey. Remember when the brake came off? And I was just sitting there? Okay, let's shut her down and read a poem. Avionics are off. Lights coming off. Put the heat in. Go idle. Turn that off. Turn the fuel off. Static elements. And we are... Thanks, White Leg. We are safe and sound at the North Pole. Nice. Okay, it's time for a poem. Okay, here we go, guys. I'll see if I can do this poem justice. It is a poem, so I'm terrible at reading poems because I don't read it exactly how it says, and then if I do and it sounds weird because it's supposed to rhyme, I fumble through it. So I will do my best on this. And again, thanks to Ryan for posting this in the Discord. But it is the aviation version of The Night Before Christmas. Let's get that warm. All right. How's the music? Probably be way better than me. Let me tone the music down a little bit more here. All right, here we go. 'Twas the night before Christmas. Already, take two. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and out on the ramp, not an airplane was stirring, not even a champ. The aircraft were fastened to tie downs with care, in hopes that morning they would be there. The fuel trucks were nestled, all snug in their spots, with winds from 240 at 39 knots. I slumped at the fuel desk, now finally caught up, and settled down comfortably, resting my butt. When the radio lit up with a noise and with a chatter, I turned up the scanner to see what was the matter. A voice clearly heard over static and snow called for clearance to land at the airport below. He barked his transmission so lively and quick. I had sworn that the call sign he used was Saint Nick. I ran to the panel to turn up the lights and better to welcome this magical flight. He called his position, no room for denial. Saint Nick won, turning left onto final. And what to my wondering eyes would appear but a Rutan-built sleigh and 8 Rotax reindeer. With vectors to final, down the glide slope he came. As he passed all the fixes, he called them by name. Now Ringo, now Tolga, now Trini, now Bakun. On Comet, on Cupid, what pills was he taking? While controllers were sitting and scratching their head, they phoned to my office and I heard it with dread. The message they left was both urgent and dour. When Santa pulls in, have him please call the tower. He landed like silk with the sled runner sparking. Then I heard left at Charlie and taxi to parking. He slowed to a taxi, turned off of 3-0, and stopped on the ramp with a ho 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 ho. He stepped out of the sleigh, but before he could talk, I ran out to meet him with my best set of chocks. His red helmet and goggles were covered with frost, and his beard was all blackened from reindeer exhaust. His breath smelled like peppermint, gone slightly stale, and he puffed on a pipe, but he didn't inhale. His cheeks were all rosy and jiggled like jelly. His boots were as black as a crop duster's belly. He was chubby and plump in his suit of bright red, and he asked me to fill it with 100 low lead. He came dashing in from the snow-covered pump. I knew he was anxious for draining the sump. I spoke not a word, but went straight to my work, and I filled up the sleigh, but I spilled like a jerk. He came out of the restroom and sighed in relief, then picked up a phone for a flight service brief. And I thought, as he silently scribed in his log, these reindeers could land in an 8-mile fog. He completed his pre-flight from the front to the rear. Then he put on his headset, and I heard him yell, "Clear!" And laying a finger on his push-to-talk, he called up the tower for clearance and squawk. "Take taxiway Charlie, the southbound direction. Turn right 320 at pilot's discretion." He sped down the runway, the best of the best. "Your traffic's a Grumman, inbound from the west." Then I heard him proclaim as he climbed through the night, "Merry Christmas to all. I have the traffic in sight." Oh, I love that. Hopefully I didn't butcher that too much, but that made me smile this morning, Ryan. So thank you for posting that. I love it. The ending to me is just the best. "Merry Christmas to all. I have the traffic in sight." It's so, so good. I read that from Ryan's post on the Discord. He posted that. I think I looked it up, and it's on like Flying Magazine. Dashing through the sky on a one-piston sleigh. So thank you, Ryan, for posting that. And
we're looking good. Oh, we're looking good.
Oh, we're looking good. And thank you to all of you for all the support and everything throughout this year. Just within this calendar year, gone from I have no idea what's going on to, you know, soloing an airplane in real life, which is super crazy. And a huge part thanks to you guys, because having the motivation, because this is so fun to stream for you guys, has helped me keep up the studying and really focus every single week. And it is because of you guys being so much fun in the Discord, in the chat, watching. So I really, really do appreciate that. Thank you, Quasar. Tim, Bill is just tying down the Bonanza right now, so he's busy. He just got got 5 o'clock shadowed Santa. I don't know how I got this on with my stupid headset on here. Well, Quasar, I appreciate that, and honestly, like, you guys just being so active and supportive, you know, with your knowledge and just being here watching and chatting is a huge, huge support. So thank you so much, Ryan. Have a great Christmas. Have a good Christmas Eve pizza party. And again, thank you for posting that that poem. That was perfect. As soon as I saw that, I go, I got to stream. I got to paint up this stupid Bonanza and read that poem, because it's too good. So I have a few things to get ready here. Going to church, coming back, Julia's brother and sister-in-law are coming over. I am cooking bacala, which is like a salt-cured cod. And the way I prepare it is like a traditional Sicilian stew. So we chop it up. You need to soak it for like a couple of days, just like in an open container of water, rinse it out a few times, get all the salt off of it, potatoes, the fish, onions, garlic, in like a tomato stew with some white wine. Oh, it's so good. We got some salad and some cannoli, some like homemade cannoli from this local, Italian market. It's going to be so good. I cannot wait. But anyway, guys, have a very, very Merry Christmas. Thank you so much for hanging out. I'm going to get this up on YouTube as well here in a little bit. I figured it would be kind of cute to post this for the next, you know, for this evening and tomorrow as well. Thank you. Have a Merry Christmas. We'll see you on Wednesday. I've got a lot of preparing to do for this cross country solo coming up on Saturday. So I'll be full on focused on that. And I'm excited for it. We'll have some really cool content in the next week. Sorry, Tim. I know Christmas duties call. So, but I will post this and have it up on YouTube here shortly. Have a great Christmas, guys, and we will see you in a couple days.